Actors, athletes, politicians, more people, public people opening up about their struggles with mental illness. Licensed counselor Rachel Glick is here to talk about that this morning, and that's where your blog is this week. You talk about people being more transparent, and it doesn't seem to have that taboo label anymore. At least it's getting there.
Right, which really helps, because the more it stays concealed, the more alone people feel, and then they don't get the help that they need. And it really only exacerbates the mental health issues.
And I've read in places where, you know, postpartum depression, people who are dealing with depression, you know, it's not a manly thing. I'm an athlete. I'm supposed to be strong. I'm an actor. I'm supposed to really be able to get through this or fake it. But people are being more transparent about their struggles.
Yes.
Can that help other people?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Especially for a lot of men, actually, there's so much pressure to that strength means keeping things, that you're strong, that you don't have vulnerable feelings, but it's that way for all of society, and that's actually just the opposite. The more we're in touch with our vulnerability and real and open with our frailties and what we're really experiencing, that's how we can actually move forward with them.
But unfortunately, in today's society, we're also dealing with bullying from the elementary school level to the middle school, high school, wherever, pro sports, where it kind of counters that. It's portrayed as weak by some.
Exactly. Yeah, we have to go against culture that's not necessarily supportive to really feeling fulfilled internally. So there's a lot of reasons why we keep things in. It's not like we make it up, and it's really not for the faint of heart to be real and honest and open and vulnerable.
And there are some steps that you wrote in your blog, start talking about it, which is what we are doing, which is what you hope others will do.
Yep.
Read and study, learn as much as you can about what's going on in your brain, right? Write it down, journal it. Does that help, really?
It does, because we don't even realize the things that we're thinking within our own minds, the conversations we're having in our head, that a thought creates a belief system, and then a belief system creates our feelings, and then our feelings are how we act and we interact, and then there's our life.
And then you can look back at that and say, okay, that's not accurate, that's not the true me here.
Exactly.
Also, make authenticity your priority. Let it out, let people know.
Right, like before you're gonna go into a vulnerable encounter, you know, we're often thinking about how we're going to come across, how we're going to be accepted.
How we're going to fake it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But if you really focus on how can I be true to myself, that's what we're never going to regret. And when we're going to leave feeling more fulfilled.
So listen, you got some reading to do. First of all, Dr. Glick's blog, it's fantastic. It gives you some great insight. Also, Bob Nightingale's article just came out yesterday in USA Today about David Freese. Any Cardinals fan wants to read it just to learn more about David Freese himself. But anybody who's concerned about mental illness and anything like this, I'm telling you, it's a fantastic read. I tweeted it as well if you want to follow it. And we have links on our website and our Fox 2 News app. Thank you very much for joining us.
My pleasure.
All right, we'll be back.